الحمد لله الذي أسعد وأشقى وأمات وأحيا وأضحك وأبقى وأفقر وأغنى والصلاة والسلام على محمد المصطفى سيد الورى شمس الهدى وعلى آله وأصحابه الخصومين بالعلم والتقى أما بعد فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم متكئين على سرر مصفوفة وزوجناهم بحور عين والذين آمنوا واتبعتهم ذريتهم بإيمان ألحقنا بهم ذريتهم وما ألتناهم من عمل من شيء كل امرئ بما كسب رهين آمنت بالله صدق الله مولانا علي الأمين إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وبارك وسلم الصلاة والسلام عليك يا سيدي يا رسول الله وعلى آلك وأصحابك يا سيدي يا حبيب الله My respected all the ulama, scholars, my brothers, elders, sisters, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today we are present at the Isal-e-Sawab ceremony of Maulana Jameel Adam, may Allah elevate his mother's soul higher in the Jannah. Today is our Isal-e-Sawab ceremony, and definitely when Muslims, they wish for someone to get higher place. When he desires for someone, that Allah may elevate his soul higher in the Dost-A'la or in the higher status of Jannah, no doubt they are the ahadith, they are the ayat of Quran, undoubtable proof we got that that benefit we took that personality. They are the people around us, they try to mislead the people, they ask for the proof, for the evidence of that. Leave the evidence, they are the certain evidence from Hadith-e Pak, the Ayah Kareema I am mentioning. This Ayah Kareema is self-explaining that. Not due to person on virtue, good deed, he gets the status of that. But due to the deed of his elders, his forefathers, those of Mu'min, they was in the high place of Jannah. Allah elevate the souls of descendants in the Jannah too. The ayah kareema I recited it. It said, Muttaqeena ala sururin maskufa wa zabbajnahum bihurin aeen. Allah explain about the mu'mineen, those did beautiful work or beautiful amal acts in the Jannah. Then Allah will provide them the cushions, comfortable places in the Jannah. And they'll get married to the hoor, those have beautiful eyes. Bihoor and Eid. Then next ayah, Allah mentioned that, وَالَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّةٌ بِإِيمَانٍ. And those follow them in the iman. وَاتَّبَعَتْهُمْ ذُرِّيَّةٌ, their descendants, their children, بِإِيمَانٍ. Only the condition is this, that those children must be mu'min. If they are mu'min, their last breath was on the status that they were Muslim, they were the follower of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Then Allah said, Al-haqna bihim turriyatahum. I take those descendants and bring them on the status where the elders are. وَمَا عَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. It does not mean that from the elders' virtues of these, I am taking out something and giving them. What they got, they will keep that with them. Their status will be the same. وَمَا عَلَتْنَاهُمْ مِنْ عَمَلِهِمْ مِنْ شَيْءٍ. كُلِّمْ رِهِمْ بِمَا كَسَبَ رَعِيمٍ. Whatever someone do in the world, he will get his portion. But due to the portion of the elders, of those who are in the higher places, they will, due to them, Allah will elevate his soul. If there's ordinary moment, I want to mention one point here. If ordinary moment, if ordinary wali, if he is in the highest places in the Jannah, his family, his children will join him in the Jannah. If ordinary moments, he is in the Jannah, his children, those who are not, you know, their deed was not so in good quality that they can weep in that status. But due to them, Allah will grant them that status too. If that was ruling for the ordinary people, the same is the ruling for the family of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His family will also join him in his status. So one thing I want to mention, that the one who made dua, no doubt his dua, when he made with the heart, definitely, as Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he motivated us on this. He said, when someone died, what is his condition? Mal mayyitu fil qabri illa kalghariq al-mutahabbis. There's the hadith we part mentioned in the famous book of Mishkatiri. It's been taught in every Sunni madaris, or even in the Deobandi madaris in Pakistan. That's famous hadith book. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned, mal mayyitu fil qabri illa kalghariq al-mutahabbis yantazir da'ata. There is the condition of the person who died. He said his condition in the grave is like someone is drowning in the water. Kalghariq al-mutaghabbis, and he asked for help. He called for help. And you know, when someone calls for help, what is your duty? To respond on his call. And what he called there, yantadir, for what he responds. He wants the response to us. Yantadir da'ata. He waits in the grave for the dua. My fathers, my brother, my elders, my son, my daughter, are they sending me the gift of dua or not? And Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when someone sends the gift of dua, and their dua has such a blessing, Allah sent the nur like a mountain in his grave. Kam salim jibal. Not the small portion of nur he gets. With the benefit of the duas of people those are behind him, he gets the swab like a mountain. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, inna adiyat al-akhya ila al-amwat. What is the best gift from the live people to the dead people? You know, when our parents or mother or father, they were alive, we were making their khidmat. We were looking after them. We were providing them medicine. We were providing them food, shelter, whatever was in our, you know, power and in our, that was our responsibility to provide them. But that was when they were alive. And when today they are not with us, what good gift could be for them? So he said, "Inna hadiyat al-akhya ila al-amwat." What the gift they need today? Al-istaghfar lahum. To make dua and maghfirat for them. So who is teaching us this? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And you know, not only those people, those was sinners in this world, they need the dua. Even those who are the pious people, they are also waiting for the dua. They are also looking for the dua. There is a hadith part, Hazrat Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal, he mentioned in his Musnad. Even Allama Ibn Majah, Imam Ibn Majah, Rahmatullah Ta'ala, he mentioned in Sunan Majah. There is a bit difference of the letters, but same meaning, both of the hadith go. Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned once there was a person in the Jannah, and after a while his status got raised in the Jannah. What he did, he performed salah, he, you know, donated zakat, whatsoever, performed hajj, he got the reward in the Jannah. But one day, all of a sudden, he has granted the highest place in the Jannah. When he got that place after a while, so he asked to Allah Ta'ala, "Ya Rabbi, anna li hadha? Oh my Lord, my Allah, why you have elevated my soul today? Whatever I did in the world, I did good work, made salah, you have rewarded me what of that. But today all of a sudden, what is the reason behind that?" So he gets the reply, "Bi-istighfari waladika lak." Today your son made dua for you, for that reason I am elevating your soul. If the someone is already in the Jannah, you make istighfar for him, he is the pious person, he is the saint, wali. You make Allah maghfirhu. So Allah elevate his soul higher. If someone in the hell, he did mistake, he is in a problem, so due to that istighfar, Allah grant him Jannah. And you know, one of the other hadith came to my mind, that the narrated by Hazrat Ibn Abbas radiallahu ta'ala anhu. And Mufassirin Ikram, they mentioned this hadith part under the ayat of, you know, in the fourth part of this ayat, Aba'u abna'u la tadruna ayyum aqrabu lakum nafa. أباكم أبناءكم لا تدرون أيهم أقرب لكم نفعا. From your father and from your children, you don't know what is more beneficial for you. Sometimes children get the benefits from their parents. If they were the good people, they were the pious people, their children get the benefits. And sometimes when the children are pious, more pious than the parents, so parents get the benefit. So Hazrat Ibn Abbas, he mentioned, "Inna al-ibna," once there was son, he was in the Jannah. Hey, he asked, "Ya Allah, I want my father to be with me. And yurfa abu ilayhi. I want my father's, his status low, and I got the highest status, and I want him to be with me." So he said, "Fayurfa ilayhi." Allah elevate the status of father to the son. Wa kadhalika al-abu. And same like, if the father's status is high, he is in the highest status of Jannah, and he desires that, "I want my mu'min son to be with me. His soul must be in the status where I am staying." So Allah elevate the soul of the son. So alhamdulillah, you know, our deen is very beautiful. And why is that? And why we are providing all these means and sources that the Sunnah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam desiring for each and every one of us to be in the Jannah. Not only due to what we did in that world, but even someone did mistake, if you know, meal being provided for the person to be in the Jannah. And Nabi Akram sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, as a mu'min, we are the luckiest people. We are so fortunate that due to him, we are getting lot of rewards. There's a time is short, but you know, two masalas are in my mind from the beginning of the dysfunction. I saw something and I must want to share that with you. Because that's our duty. One thing is that Allah Rabbul Izzat mentioned in the Quran, وَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنِ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْصِتُوا. When the Quran is being recited, it is our duty that we must listen to that. When someone is reading, one person is reading in loud voice, so all of other people, they have to listen, don't recite with him. If he is reading in his heart, then everyone can recite it. Because Quran is saying, when someone reciting Quran, the other duty is that they must listen him and concentrate what he is saying. Whenever is the function, is the khatam, you listen as someone is reciting. So we have to listen to him. We don't have to recite with him. The other thing that I want you to pay concentration on this, when you go to Mizar, never ever prostrate in front of Mizar. It is haram. It is totally forbidden. You can kiss Mizar. You can kiss the grave of your parents, your mother, your father, even the saints. But never ever put your forehead in front of that person. That is not the respect and love. Even the person who is in the grave, he won't like it. How he can like it if we are going against the teaching of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam? We are going against the teaching of Islam. They will be happy on us. And definitely when they will be happy on us, they will make dua for us. When we will go according to the Islamic teaching. So it is our job, when we go in the Midan, most respectful way, you can kiss there.